Hello everyone. Today we will look at the policy responses of the government in the agriculture sector, or to remove the problems or to address the problems in the agriculture sector. Here we are going to look at the food management in India, which has emerged as one of the key problem. Food management, it is one of the major problem with losses amounting to lakhs of crores. If we look at the data, then the annual post-harvest losses in India stands at 92,651 crore. This much amount of post-harvest losses takes place in India because of various issues like issues in distribution, procurement, food storage, etc. So it becomes essential that we focus on food storage, procurement and distribution. Effective food management will ensure higher agriculture growth rate, as post-harvest losses will reduce and that much income will go to the farmers. It is believed that the food, efficient food production and food management will help in achieving twin goals, which are poverty reduction and economic growth and agricultural growth. Let us look at what is food management. Food management is procurement of food grains from farmers at MSP or the remunerative prices or minimum support prices, distribution of food grains to the consumers, maintenance of food buffers for food security and price stability. This is all is known as food management. In India, the Food Corporation of India procures the grain at minimum support price, which is announced by the central government. As per the Food and Agricultural Organization, FAO, food security exists when all the people at all the time have physical and economic access to sufficient, safe and nutritious food that meets their dietary needs and food preference to ensure an active and healthy life. So every government strives that food security exists in their economy and people do have access to an affordable and qualitative food. The Food Corporation of India undertakes procurement and storage of food grains in India. And if we look at the global ranking in the food management of food security, then in the Global Food Security Index, India's rank was 72 in the year 2019. And in the Global Hunger Index, India's rank stood at 102 in 2019. Coming to the food storage, in India, Central Warehousing Corporation, State Warehousing Corporation and private warehouses are used for storage of food grains, which are procured by the Food Corporation of India and various state government. The total food storage capacity in our country is very less as compared to the requirements because of various issues. There has been concerns regarding wastage of stored food grains due to inadequate storage system. And this is because of the prevalence of cover and plinth system, wherein food grains get damaged during rainy season. The total capacity of the food grain in India stands at 750 million ton. Out of this, 617 million ton is in cover godam and 132 is in cover and plinth system. The private entrepreneur guarantee scheme was launched by the central government so that the storage capacity in India can be boosted. The storage capacity is usually created by private parties or under PPP mode or through government agencies, and that storage is hired by the Food Corporation of India for a period of 9 to 10 years, and the annual charges are paid for the storage capacity which is leased. This ensures that the government is not required to do so much investment in the storage capacity, because that investment is done by the private party and government can lease that storage system. Under the PEG scheme, steel silos are constructed for modernization of storage infrastructure and improving shelf life, because steel silos are modern storage infrastructure and they ensure that food grains are not destroyed. Apart from this, online depot management system was also started, which automated the process of all depot operations like receipt of food grains, storage, maintenance activity and issue of food grains against the receipts. Thus, it becomes essential for a country to have a sufficient or adequate food storage capacity so that sufficient reserves can also be maintained of the food grains. Now, as you've seen, procurement has been done, storage has also been done. Now that stored food grains has to be distributed. For this, National Food Security Act of 2013 is there, Under the NFSA Act of 2013, food grains are distributed to Antyodaya Anna Yojana beneficiaries and priority households. The NFSA is the world's largest food security program, which covers 75% of the rural population and 50% of the urban population in our country under the Target Public Distribution System scheme. The importance of the NFSA Act can also be seen in the current ongoing pandemic of COVID-19, because government is using the NFSA Act efficiently to distribute food grains and to ensure that faces hunger issue during the pandemic, and food grains are distributed for free to the beneficiaries under the TPDS or those who are poor. Two types of beneficiaries are there under the NFSA Act. One is Antyodaya Anna Yojana and second is priority household. The Antyodaya Anna Yojana are the poorest of the poor, and they receive 35 kg of food grains per household per month, whereas the priority household receive 5 kg per person per month food grains. Till date, more than 600 lakh tons of subsidized food grains has been distributed to 81 crore beneficiaries through a link of 5 lakh ration shops. And currently, apart from this fixed subsidized food grain, additional food grain is also provided at free of cost. The price of the food grain is at central issue price, which is determined by the government. For rice, it is rupees 3 per kg. For wheat, it is rupees 2 per kg. And for coarse cereals, it is rupees 1 per kg. 5 kg of subsidized food grains are provided against the ration cards. And it depends whether you are a beneficiary under priority household or Antyodaya Anna Yojana. The NFSA has been emerged as one of the largest food security program in the best way to tackle poverty and hunger. Coming to the procurement of food grain at MSP is done by Food Corporation of India and various state governments. The procurement is through decentralized manner, and the procured food grains are also sold in the market through open market sale so that the price stability in the market can be maintained. The procurement cost, the procurement is done. So the economic cost of the food grains which are procured is the pooled cost of food grain, the procurement incidental and the distribution cost. The economic cost and tells us about the subsidy which the government is going to pay to the Food Corporation of India. In order to calculate the food subsidy, we have to minus the per quintal economic cost with the central issue price. So the central issue price for coarse cereal is rupees 1. Just deduct that central issue price with a per quintal economic cost. For example, rupees 200 per quintal is the economic cost of wheat. Now the central issue price of wheat is rupees 2. So if you minus it, the food subsidy for wheat per quintal or 100 kg will be 198. So that is the food subsidy. There are concerns that the food subsidy in India is rising, and this is because of various reasons. One is food grain stocks are much higher than their norms. The economic cost and the MSP were increased. MSP was enhanced and economic cost got increased because of various issues like rise in cost or in procurement, incidental transportation cost, etc. The average central issue price for the APL household was reduced, and it is very less. In the year 2018, rupees 1,71,000 crore was released as a food subsidy, and it is believed that in the current FY 2020-21, the food subsidy bill might exceed rupees 2 lakh crore, because government is providing certain amount of food grains to more than 70 crore people free of cost. If you look at the data from, I have taken this from Food Corporation of India. Here, the operational stock of food grain and the strategic reserves, you can see. For the strategic reserve for rice and wheat is 20 and 30, 20 million ton and 30 million ton. This is the strategic reserve that the government is to ensure that Food Corporation of India is maintaining. But actually, the strategic reserves are much higher, which the FCI is maintaining. It is more than 40 million ton for wheat and more than 30 million ton for rice. And that's why it is said that the excess capacity is there, excess food grain storage is there, which need to be distributed, or else it will get destroyed. Now let us look at the recommendation of the Ashok Dalwai Committee. The Ashok Dalwai Committee was constituted for rectifying the issues in the storage capacity and enhancing the food storage capacity in India. The key recommendation was prepare a district and statewide storage plan, and the new storage capacity addition should be in silos, steel silos and modern warehouses. So avoid usage of cover and plinth system and prepare the plan at district level as well. Enhance the usage of negotiable warehousing receipts. It will encourage the reduction in the cases of distress sale, and all the stakeholders should be included while implementing the negotiable warehousing receipts. So it will reduce distress sale, because distress sale happens when farmer needs money immediately or he doesn't have a storage capacity. If negotiable warehousing receipts will be there, farmers can store their food grains, can get a NWR and can get a loan against that receipt. So distress sale will be avoided. The third recommendation was increase accreditation of cold storage. Increase the number of cold storage system in India. Ensure that those cold storage are accredited, and existing cold storage infrastructure should also be accredited. So accreditation is the prime importance. So this was the recommendation of the Ashok Dalwai Committee. It is very, very important. Now we will look at few practice questions. Question first is, what is the correct formula to estimate the economic cost of food grain procurement? We have already seen this formula in this slide. The correct is pooled cost of food grain procurement, incidental and distribution cost. Option 1 is right, because option 2, 3, 4 are all of them are wrong, because transportation cost is already included in procurement and incidental. Option 2 will be wrong. The third option is procurement and distribution cost. It doesn't include the procurement and incidental cost. It only includes the distribution and pooled cost. Option 4th is also wrong, because it includes pooled cost, storage cost and distribution cost. It does not include the incidental cost. Question 2nd, effective food management ensures higher GDP growth rate, low industrial growth rate, help in achieving twin goals of poverty reduction and agri-growth, and decline in India's ranking in GFSI. Here you have to select the closest one. The correct will be help in achieving twin goals of poverty reduction and agriculture growth. When poverty reduction will take place, the GDP growth rate will also increase, because the agriculture growth is also increasing. Now you have to select the closest one here. So closest answer will be option 3. So thank you.